German appears to be the Esperanto of Middle Europe, the vehicle which unites beyond ethnic boundaries. The unifying and supranational factor par excellence was the Jewish-German symbiosis. The tragedy of Middle Europe lies too in the fact that this symbiosis ended in the way we know, with the destruction of one element at the hands of the other. Literature endowed Danubian civilization with the genus face of a double truth, the nostalgia for order and the unmasking of disorder. Mid-European civilization pursued its dream of a harmonious totality, and as such it has, after so many tragic historical disintegrations, fascinated the collective imagination. Yet it seems a civilization whose very nostalgic passion for harmony compelled it to discover and expose the fragmentation of the real. All the enthusiasm for Mid-European culture is not for the image of an ordered world, but rather for the vigor with which the culture produced by that world exposed the vacancy, the falseness, and the disorder of the same world, and of the world as a whole. Austria and Middle Europe seem to be not Zweig's secure world of yesterday, so much as the Wetterstation für Weltuntergang, meteorological office for the end of the world, described by Karl Kraus. It is Mid-European civilization which, in Moses' Men Without Qualities, invents the parallel action. The parallel action is a committee in search of a central idea to celebrate as the cornerstone of Austrian and indeed all Western civilization. But the idea cannot be found. When this culture investigates its own first principle, the basic value on which it is founded, it discovers that there isn't one. The empire and all Middle Europe expose the emptiness of all reality, which, I quote, steht in der Luft, is built on air. The culture of Middle Europe unmasked Western civilization insofar as that civilization has no foundation, unity, or order. It was Hermann Broch who identified the old Austria with the emperor's empty box, the box reserved in every theater, in every city, throughout the double monarchy, against possible visits by the sovereign, heart and fulcrum of that world, who, however, never appears, either in that box or in any of the other boxes, in all the theaters, in all the cities, never or practically never, but is absent.